Yes, this movie is better than The Dark Knight. What's up, fuckers? It's me, the Batman. Totally, for real, I swear. March 3rd, 2022, I went down to Leo Little fucking movie theater and I saw The Batman. And I think it's safe to say that this is easily the best Batman movie. Scratch that. The best movie about Batman they have made. Meaning that it is a better movie than The Dark Knight, not just a better Batman movie like other people are saying. It is an objectively better movie than The Dark Knight. I'm just saying that. Just putting that out there. I know I'm in the minority with this, but I don't give a shit because it's, quite frankly, it's true. Robert Pattinson's performance as the Batman was just great. As Batman and Bruce Wayne, I know there's a lot of complaints out there saying that he didn't make a good Bruce Wayne because he was too brooding, and that's because at this point in the in his, you know, character arc, he doesn't realize the importance of the Bruce Wayne persona. He's just solely focused on the Batman. He doesn't care about Bruce Wayne. He doesn't care about the he just cares about being Batman. He just cares about being Batman, and that's all that's important to him. And throughout the movie, he realizes that he needs to approach fighting crime differently in Gotham, which and throughout the movie he realizes that he needs to approach crime fighting differently, and that's kind of, you know, gonna lead to, at least I imagine, to him improving the Bruce Wayne persona and actually starting to, you know, do shit as Bruce Wayne, as Bruce Wayne, and not just as Batman. But yeah, he gave a fantastic performance. You can, he's a great actor. He doesn't, I don't think he has that much lines, like, actually, in the entire movie. But you just always know what he's feeling. You always know what he's thinking because of his facial expressions. He's a good physical actor, and it really shines through in the role as in his role as Batman. Paul Dano does a really good job as the Riddler. Now, in my theater, I saw some people just like laugh at how crazy he was, but in all honesty, dude was fucking intimidating. Like, yeah, it was a little bit over the top, but that's how a fucking crazy narcissistic person would behave. Fucking loud and fucking, I don't know, like showman-esque, you know? Yeah, like very, I don't know how to describe it, but that's exactly how I would expect someone who's ego-driven and crazy and self-obsessed, like the Riddler, would behave in any given situation. And I think Paul Dano pulls it off very well. He is intimidating. He's not a physical threat, but he is a very large mental threat, which is a very welcome change in Batman movies in general, because we're typically used to him fighting against someone who can physically challenge him, like Bane, fucking Bat, Mr. Freeze, Poison Ivy, the Joker. Yeah, but Paul Dano, the Riddler, obviously was not going to be a physical challenge to him. And he still did a good job. He still was, you know, yeah. I don't know, but yeah, he did a good job. Zoe Kravitz's Catwoman, she wasn't really in the movie that much, if I remember, but from what she was in, it was, you know, it was enjoyable. She did a good job. She definitely did a better job than Anne Hathaway. You can see why. She was very pivotal. She was very pivotable. She had a very important role in the movie. She basically only ever showed up to advance the plot. Like, when Catwoman showed up, you knew, all right, shit's gonna happen. There's gonna be no conflict. Like, an integral story beat is about to happen. We have to pay attention. And, you know, that's fine. That was good writing. And also, Zoe Kravitz does a really good job as Selina Kyle and actually makes you care about her. I did not give a shit as Anne Hathaway's Catwoman. I'm sorry. I did not. She could have died and I wouldn't have cared. I'm sorry. Michelle Pfeiffer is different, though. Gordon, again, wasn't in the movie much, as if I can remember correctly, but again, still did a great job. Jeffrey Wright is a really good actor. He is really good as Gordon, and you can really feel like him and Batman have been doing this for a while. They have a dynamic going on. It feels like they're just friends, you know? As distant as Batman is, but yeah, you can still feel it. Penguin doesn't show up much in the movie. He's like a very, very minor... He has a very, very minor role in the movie. He's not really part of the main plot. He's more of a... I don't want to say plot device, but... I don't know. I don't know what he is, but he doesn't really serve a main function in the movie. He's just, I guess, a red herring and throughout the entire thing. And he's like a proto Penguin at this point. He's not the Penguin. He's not even a mob boss. He's like the laughing stock of the mob boss community. And it sets into motion his takeover as like the big bad gangster mob boss of Gotham. And I think it does a really good job setting that into place. So that's really all I have to say about the characters. I want to get into some other complaints that I've been hearing about the movie, which is basically just, it's not funny enough. Which, hey, this movie has plenty of jokes. Like, trust me. A lot of them are spoiler-ish, so I'm not going to say them, but they have plenty of jokes. The difference is, it doesn't fucking slow the movie. It doesn't bring the movie to a grinding halt to make a really bad quip. The jokes in this movie, they're natural, they're organic, they're, you know, jokes that someone would make in real life, not just, hey, let me stop you right there. Let's make a joke. All right, let's keep going. No, it's just natural flowing conversation, you know, it's jokes, just... I don't know what to say. It's natural flowing joke. It's things that you'd expect people to say in real life, you know? It's good writing. I'm not saying that the MCU is bad writing, but I'm not saying it's good writing either. But there's jokes in this movie. People saying it's too dark. What did you expect? It's a fucking Batman movie. Very clearly people did expect jokes, but come on. It's a fucking Batman movie. He's not exactly the brightest, happiest superhero. Ignore this picture. He's not exactly the brightest, happiest superhero there is. But whatever. The cameo at the end. Without getting into spoilers, there's a cameo at the end of the movie. It was not needed. It really wasn't. I get why he kept it in there. But at the same time, I would have much preferred it if they didn't. But I'm fine with it because I know it's not a tease to a sequel. They basically said later in interviews, Matt Reeves said it later in interviews that it's more of a setup to the Arkham spinoff series that they're going to have. And I hope that's true because I really hope that we can have a trilogy. We can have an incarnation of the character without this guy showing up, you know? I feel like that gave away who the cameo is, but it doesn't matter. I feel like we've seen enough of him. We don't need more in a movie. But whatever, it's fine. I get why he was included, though. I just don't think it was necessarily needed. The 3-hour runtime, a lot of people are saying this movie can be trimmed down. But in all honesty, I can't find a scene where you can cut fat. There's not any fat in this movie as far as I'm concerned. This movie is straightforward, straight to the point, and, you know, really digestible for all you slow people in the audience. Batman's a detective, you know, he does detective things, and people saying that, oh, I don't know. People are complaining about this movie seemingly because it's not an MCU movie. And trust me, I like the MCU. Look at this shit. You think everybody has this shit in their house? Fucking, where's the button? You think everyone just has this shit in their house? No. I love the MCU. Well, loved the MCU. Not so much now. I'm kind of jaded to it. Anyway, but this is still better than, like, anything they've pumped out. And this is still a good movie, so there's no reason to hate on it just because you're a Marvel fan. I don't know. The Marvel versus DC thing, it's been getting old, bro. It's been old. Come on. Do better shit with your life, man. It's like, this is the new version of fucking iPhone versus Samsung shit. Everybody who was fighting that argument got told they're being stupid, so they moved on to this shit. Point is, this movie's great. Watch it, 10 out of 10, and I do not say that lightly. I actually do, but I really mean it this time. You should definitely go watch The Batman, because it is really, really, really good. Yeah, later, motherfuckers. Something.